नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम् I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the practicing living Hindus all over the world and all the Kailasavasis and Kailasa Viswasis, SJP, Kartas, Yajamans, Srimahans, Mahans, Tanidar, Kotari, Kayakalpa Yoga participants, Kailasas, E-Gurukul students, Kailasas, NHU students, and the participants of Paramashivoham, Level 2, participants who have logged in from all over the world having Nayana Diksha. I welcome all of you with my love and respect. I welcome everyone watching us live on Kailasa TV, Kailasa's NTV, Kailasa's Hinduism Now TV, Kailasa's Enlighten App, Kailasa's Nayana Diksha and other social media platforms such as YouTube Live, Facebook Live and Twitter. I welcome all of you with my love and respect. Today's message from Paramashiva directly from Kailasa views and solution Hindu solution for post-COVID-19 world. Hindu solutions for the post-corona world. In Hindu tradition, whenever somebody falls sick or quarantined due to some reason, in Hindu tradition, quarantine is used in multiple various situations of life, like if somebody is dead in your family, near and dear one. The whole family is quarantined exactly, precisely same 16 days. The time usually taken for the virus strain to break. In many situations, in Hindu tradition, quarantine is used. Whenever somebody is sick or under quarantine, that person is expected to do Shravana and Manana, means listening to the great truths, powerful cognition. And intranalyze. Shravana means collecting cosmic cognition, listening to the great truths, powerful cognition. Manana means mapping them to your life. Intranalyze. In Hindu tradition, whenever you are sick or quarantined, you are expected to do Shravana and Manana, listening to higher truths and intranalyzing them, to internalize. Now, almost whole world is quarantined. Even though only small number of people are sick compared to the population of the planet Earth, only small percentage is sick, but rest of them are quarantined. So the world is going through an unexpected or unimaginable situation. The true causes of the COVID-19 pandemic is still unknown. How it is going to impact the world, humanity, still unknown. COVID-19 has swept the whole world. COVID-19 has swept the world in a global pandemic of extraordinary proportion. Not just the health costs, The quarantine. Which is mandatory to protect ourselves and all the other prevention methods we have to follow to protect the large population from this global pandemic. Its direct and indirect effect on economy, most importantly, how it is going to affect our survival needs like food, clothes, shelter, especially the less privileged, whom we call poor, for whom the resources are not immediately available. That section of the society is going to really be hit by this global pandemic. Understand? Centers for Disease Control estimates suggested anywhere between 200,000 to 1.7 million deaths could be expected in the United States alone, depending on the eventual fatality rate. I don't even want to complete the sentence. It's just terrifying. I don't want to utter inauspicious words and put fear. But let me give you the Hindu solution. First thing I want to tell, all the Hindus, O Hindus of the world, even though we may not be responsible or reason for this global pandemic, we should take the responsibility to find a solution how to handle this crisis the humanity is facing. Understand? We may not be the reason for this global pandemic, but we Hindus should take the responsibility to find solution for this global pandemic and its direct and indirect effect on humanity. From today, next few days, continuously, I am going to reveal views and suggestions, Hindu solution for all the COVID-19 related problems, issues, impact of COVID-19 directly and indirectly on humanity. The first step we Hindus need to do is collecting the cosmic cognitions, listening to the powerful truth and mapping them to our conscious Shravana Manana, collecting and mapping, contemplating. The first point we need to do Shravana and Manana, listening and internalizing, is karma. Why this COVID-19, the coronavirus problem, the COVID-19 pandemic, we need to understand the cosmic logic. Understand? Modern day human beings are so enamored by the binary logic and its utility values in day-to-day life. Understand, the binary logic is useful for modern day human being in so many ways in their day-to-day life, no doubt. To do all your transactions, interactions, in every level of your life, binary logic is so useful, and you are enamored by the binary logic. We forgot there is something like cosmic logic exists. Understand? Cosmic logic is karma. Whenever we face a problem which cannot be addressed, attended by the binary logic, when binary logic falls short to give solution, we need to look up to cosmic logic. Multidimensional logic. Karma is cosmic logic. In simple words, if I have to define karma, cosmic logic and the way life of the cosmos, which is independent intelligence, acts reacts and responds is karma. Beautifully, Brihadaranyaka Upanishad defines karma. See, the karma as multiple definitions and understanding. I will give you one definition of karma, which is apt for us to listen and internalize during this situation, for this crisis. Yatakari, yatachari, tatabhavati, sadhukari, sadurbhavati, papakari, papobhavati, punya punyena karmana bhavati papa papena. This is Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, fourth adhyaya, fourth brahmanam, fifth mantra. I'll give you the translation. As it does and acts, so it becomes. By doing good, it becomes good. And by doing evil, it becomes evil. It becomes virtuous through good acts and vicious through evil acts. I'll give you one more definition of karma, the cosmic logic, which is needed for all of us to listen and internalize during this crisis. Again, this definition is from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, which is the source of Hindu scriptures. Third adhyaya, second brahmanam, 13th mantra. Karma haiva tat prasatu punyo vai punyena karmana bhavati papa papeneti. Therefore, one indeed becomes good through good work and evil through evil work. We need to internalize this definition of the cosmic logic. What is the papa we did? Understand? Hinduism asks us to internalize only to build powerful future, not to collapse into guilt or powerlessness about the past. Please understand, the concept of sin is used in modern day to put you in guilt, collapse you, make you powerless mentally, psychologically, emotionally weak, to be exploited. But Hindu concept of papa is never used to put you in guilt, fear, and make you powerless and break you mentally or psychologically, emotionally. No. Be very clear. Be informed. The Hindu concept of papa, the cosmic logic, the karma, is taught to you the secrets about cosmic logic, knowledge of the cosmic logic, karma, is revealed to you only to make you powerful and create a new future, to live powerfully and undo all the mistakes committed in the past due to delusion, ignorance. Understand? The concept of Papa is completely different from the concept of sin. So, we need to understand the cosmic logic. Why COVID-19 on us, humanity? If we intra-analyze this truth, we can build new future for us, eliminating this papas, aligning ourselves more to the cosmic logic. So we can avoid this kind of pandemic crisis in future. We can have the better world. The first truth, the first understanding we need to have is purpose of the world, the primal principle, the primary principle of the universe is let us all coexist and celebrate our life. Planet Earth may be ruled by human beings, but we have no right to feel this planet Earth is exclusively for human beings. No. That is the sin. That is the papa human beings are committing. When we are enamored by the binary logic, we fall in love with binary logic and forget the existence of cosmic logic. So when you are enamored by this beautiful planet Earth and all the resources it can offer to make your life comfortable and luxurious, you forget this planet Earth belongs to all other beings also. Out of extreme greed and delusion, we try to make this planet Earth exclusively for us human beings is the first sin, papa, we are committing. Let us stop this thought current of trying to make this planet Earth exclusively for us by making all other beings extinct. Understand? In last 100 years, the damage, destruction we did to planet Earth is unimaginable. Due to our greed, due to our extreme possessiveness, just because binary logic makes our life more comfortable and luxurious, we forget the cosmic logic, karma exists. Same way, just because the beautiful things this planet earth can offer to make our life comfortable and luxurious. We are trying to possess this planet earth exclusively for us human beings. Understand? We are not just winning the nature, we are trying to kill nature. Billions of animals are killed for food every day. Whether for your food, or medicine, or cosmetics, or things which makes you comfortable, or luxurious needs, whatever may be the purpose, but we are forgetting the most important cosmic logic. Let us all coexist and celebrate life. Ahimsa paramo dharma. Non-violence is the ultimate natural law of life, cosmic logic of life. Ahimsa paramo dharma. Non-violence is the ultimate principle of cosmic logic. The extreme greed is making human beings possessive of planet Earth, and just for our taste buds, we are ready to kill billions of animals. It is not even to satisfy the hunger. Satisfying the hunger, keeping yourself healthy is verily possible with vegetarian lifestyle, with plant-based diet, food and lifestyle. We all know planet Earth cannot afford any more meat-based lifestyle. Planet Earth cannot afford, simply cannot afford, for multiple reasons, not only as per the cosmic logic, even as per the binary logic, planet Earth cannot afford meat-based lifestyle. Killing animals, killing life for our taste buds is no more practical lifestyle as per cosmic logic and as per binary logic, in both levels. Whether the amount of grain, water, land, resources needed for producing meat, or the amount of pain, suffering, torture, cruelty caused while you are killing the animals for your food or for milk. Understand? Milk comes from the industry which is most violent. large quantity of milk supply is from violent. Dairy forms. It's very little, almost negligible quantity only comes from non-violent goshala. We are forgetting the pain, karma, suffering we are causing as per the cosmic logic to the world, and the amount of resources spent on producing meat, even as per the binary logic, in both levels, as per the cosmic logic and as per the binary logic, in both levels, meat eating lifestyle is impractical. I request and recommend all Hindus to renounce meat eating lifestyle for the sake of saving the planet Earth. I humbly request all practicing Hindus, living Hindus, to renounce meat eating lifestyle. To save planet Earth, let us not be possessive. Let us not try to make this planet Earth exclusively for human beings. Let's stop this delusional greed. The greed of the human beings has reached to the level of delusion. We are in a delusion of thinking we can make the planet Earth exclusively for human beings, which is not possible. Please understand. Oh humanity, please wake up. Three-year research project published in the Lancet, leading scientific journal in UK, outlined what a panel of nutrition, agriculture and environmental experts believe is the best way to eat for our own health and planet's health. And it looks very different from what most people eat. Big changes are necessary. The report contains, it recommends a plant-based diet based on previously published studies that have linked red meat to increased risk of health problems. It also comes amid recent studies of how eating habits affect the environment. Producing red meat takes up land and feed to raise cattle, which emit the greenhouse gas methane. I want to reveal these two important secrets of the cosmic logic for all of us to internalize, contemplate, do manana. One, karma, cosmic logic, and second is ahimsa, cosmic solution. Cosmic logic is karma, cosmic solution is dharma. The karma you need to understand and the dharma you need to understand. Ahimsa, Chandogya Upanishad beautifully describes ahimsa. Sansarva bhutanyatra, sansarva bhutanyanyatra tirthebhya sa kalvevam vartayanyavatayusham brahmalokamapi sampatyate nacha punaravartate nacha punaravartate. This is Chandogya Upanishad 8th kanda, 15th kanda, first mantra. Understand? I'll give the translation. Never causing pain to any living beings except in places specially ordained. One who behaves thus throughout life reaches the abode of Brahman, does not return, does not return. Means, if you desire a non-violent lifestyle, you reach the highest existence and you never need to fall into the lower existence. Ahimsa paramo dharma. Non-violence is the highest value. Understand? Cosmic logic is karma, cosmic solution is dharma. I will reveal various sacred secrets from cosmic logic and cosmic solution. About this COVID-19 pandemic and COVID-19 crisis in further satsangs every day for next few days. So today, contemplate on these two sacred secrets, karma and dharma. Cosmic logic and cosmic solution. The essence of today's satsang, cosmic logic, karma of COVID-19 crisis and cosmic solution, dharma for COVID-19 crisis is ahimsa, non-violence, blissful coexistence. With this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing. Living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, living and radiating the state, space, powers, being, सुपर कॉन्शियसनेस एंड कैलास ऑफ परमशिव परमशिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परमशिवोहम द एटर्नल ब्लिस Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.